Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. On Friday, SpaceX launched the Starlink 431 mission on a Falcon 9 rocket.
4, engines full power, and liftoff. Go Starlink, go Falcon 9, go Starlink.
The booster which launched this mission, B1063, then landed successfully for the 8th time on the drone ship of Course I Still Love You.
And there you can see on your left hand screen, the landing burn has begun on this booster. Let's watch as it touches down on Of Course I Still Love You.
Landing leg deploy.
And back shutdown.
And awesome
stage view confirmed.
Of that landing, the Falcon has landed.
The upcoming Falcon Heavy launch has been delayed slightly, but not a huge amount, as SpaceX posted this tweet. They said, static fire of Falcon Heavy complete. Targeting Tuesday, November 1st for the launch of the USS F-44 mission from Launch Complex 39A in Florida. So as of now, the launch of Falcon Heavy USS F-44 is scheduled for Tuesday, November 1st at 1:40 PM UTC or 9:40 AM EDT. In addition to that, there should be a launch a couple of days after with some more Galaxy satellites. As you can see on the SpaceX Fans website, the launch of Galaxy 31 and 32 is scheduled for Thursday 3rd at 3:25 AM UTC or Wednesday 2nd at 11:35 PM EDT. With the Falcon Heavy tweet, SpaceX also posted this cool picture of Falcon Heavy performing the static fire test. There was some interesting information in a SpaceX FCC filing about the Starlink constellation. It says, additionally, SpaceX hereby notifies the Commission of its intent following issuance of the Gen 2 license to seek a modification of its V-band authorization to significantly reduce the total number of satellites ultimately in orbit. Heading to Boca Chica, here's a view of the progress on the structure being added behind the mega bay. There's a new tent going up near the propellant production site. There's a ship nose cone chilling at the production site, possibly for ship 27. Here's a view of another ship nose being worked on inside the tent. Jeff Faust posted a couple of tweets related to Starship and HLS. The first says, Rene Ortega, NASA's HLS chief engineer, is clearly impressed with access to data SpaceX has provided during Starship tests and its hardware-rich approach during a conference panel. It's a big deal. Then he posted a second saying, but a lack of technical details or Starship HLS development updates from NASA and SpaceX in a too short panel, less than 20 minutes with no audience questions. Marcia Smith from Space Policy Online posted a tweet about NASA's plans for Starship and the Artemis 4 mission. It says, following up on Jeff Faust's intriguing tweet from this morning from Von Braun 2022, I asked NASA if plans have indeed changed for Artemis 4 and now include a landing. They have. After the previous full-stack cryo testing, there was some more full-stack cryo testing during the week. Taking a look at the Roden Beach closures, there are some dates this coming week. There is a temporary and intermittent road delay scheduled for tomorrow, Monday 31st. However, in addition, there is also a possible closure scheduled for tomorrow. Plus, there are possible closures for Tuesday, November 1st and Wednesday, November 2nd as well. Here's the upper tank of Booster 9 inside the Mega Bay. As always, I have to say thanks to Nick Ansuini and Jack Beyer, who have both been out there recently filming the Boca Chica content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.